Roth cleaned the dirt from under her nails with her teeth. It was a nervous and dirty habit. Kathy was always getting on her case about it. But considering the circumstances at the moment, she really didn't give a flying fuck about biting her nails. The two heads of Chigusa Onworld stood over her small table in the rec centre and glowered at her. Creep snuffled blissfully by her feet, probably thrilled to get out of the sun. She wished she felt the same. Do you know what charges you could face if Ackland's Rinth turned up infected with dangerous bacteria or a virus? Hiroki had always been an amiable sort, but his eyes flashed with anger. At her. And you were responsible for sending them to Earth? Roth opened her mouth to speak, but was cut off by the Noguchi woman. Ms. Roth, if anything has happened to Keizo Revna, you will be held accountable. She leaned towards Roth, expression cold. How do you feel about that? He's been missing for almost a day now. He might be injured. Or dead. Roth nodded slowly. She'd lied for Ackland, to put her reputation at stake for him. After all, he was the boss. But she wasn't about to get caught holding this bag. It was just a little bit too heavy. Ackland told me to, she said quietly. I realize that doesn't excuse my actions, but I just work for the man, you know? Hiroki and Noguchi exchanged glances. So Ackland told you to tell Revna that the spider creatures were Iowa Gorge? Noguchi leaned forward again, but her eyes weren't as angry as before. Right. What the hell is going on here? Roth looked up, surprised. Ackland marched across the room, his face sweaty and red. Roth, what have you done? Ackland stopped at their table and glared down at her accusingly. What's this I hear about you lying to Doc Revna? Roth felt raw anger hit her system. He was going to let her take the fall, after she'd worked her ass off for him for 3 years. What a surprise. She stood abruptly. Mr. Ackland, I've already explained the situation. And I quit. And I expect to be paid within the month. Roth nodded at Noguchi and Hiroki. Please let me know if I can help in any way, and contact me about any charges as soon as you've decided. She whistled softly. Creep jumped up to follow her to the exit. Already she could hear Ackland's voice raised in a huff. I thought a man had a right to be present when his accusers were testifying against him. She was glad to get out. Ackland talked big, there would be quite a scene, but he had enough sense to know when he was caught. Hiroki was a fair man, but Noguchi? Something about her was pure steel. Roth would hate to cross that one. Nitrogen Queen was right. So you were planning to try me in absentia? Don't you need a judge to hold a trial? Or is that some old-fashioned notion? Shut up, Ackland. Stunned, he did. You violated company policy and jeopardized the security of this complex and its personnel, Ackland. I figure that's all the legal authority I need. Noguchi was royally pissed, but she kept her voice low. This overblown rancher had the gall to try and screw things up for everyone and then cover it up. You really think you've got the backing to make charges stick? In case you haven't noticed, you aren't exactly the most popular person in this settlement. Ackland was shaken, she could tell, but he smirked at her. You're right, I'm just the new boss. She had to make a conscious effort not to shout. But Doc Revna has been here since the beginning, treating the rancher's stock, treating their families, delivering their babies. So far, he's just missing. But if he turns up dead, who do you think folks are going to side with? You or his grieving widow? Ackland seemed to shrink a little in front of her. He dropped his gaze to the unlit cigar he held and spoke uneasily. Look, I didn't expect the doctor to go out looking for more of those things. Hiroki stepped in. But if he did, you want to make sure that he looked in the wrong place. Ackland flared again, but his anger seemed weak. We had no way of knowing whether those rinth were infected or not. I didn't want to delay the whole operation. Hiroki frowned angrily and pointed his finger at the rancher's chest. Didn't it occur to you that trouble with your herd could be the reason the lector is still parked out front? Noguchi raised her eyebrows. What? Yeah, I meant to tell you, Hiroki started, but she was already headed to one of the small wall screens. She punched up a southern compound view and looked in disbelief. Those rinth are going to be hell to manage after standing in the sun all day. She turned to glare accusingly at Ackland. He looked away. Noguchi tapped into operations. Collins appeared in front of her. Collins, why hasn't the lector taken its first load back to the orbiter? I couldn't say, Machiko. We've been trying to contact them all day, but they haven't responded. Send someone in person. Collins nodded. I'll go myself. Good. And don't waste your time with Conover. talk to Strandberg. Remind him we're on a tight schedule and report back immediately, okay? Gotcha. The screen went blank. At least that was taken care of. She walked back to the table where Ackland had sat down, his face blank. If this has anything to do with your little lie, Ackland, she said smoothly, calmly, I'll see to it that you're put away for it until hell freezes solid. The look in his eyes, defeated and guilty, was exactly what she wanted. Scott ached all over. It was the hangover, and that Japanese woman, she was responsible, except he couldn't move his arms, and he was standing up. He opened his heavy eyelids and blinked several times. It was dark, but he was inside. There was weak light coming from somewhere. Tom? His voice was a raspy croak. God, he was thirsty. He cleared his throat and tried again. Tom, can you answer me? No answer. Was he in a med center, maybe? There might have been some kind of accident. He took a deep breath and spoke as loud as he could. Hello? Where am I? Tom? His throat protested. It felt like he'd swallowed a bucket of sand. A slow hissing filled the room. The shadows in the room moved, unfurled themselves from the walls and the dark corners. He could make out teeth. Jesus. He tried to move, but his arms were pinned. Oh God, no. His voice was barely a whisper. The room swam with darkness, and then once again, there was nothing. The company has billions invested in this project, she continued. Where the hell do you get off fucking with us? Not to mention possibly endangering the lives of millions, maybe billions of people. You think the quarantine laws are just there for the fun of it? She was still on a roll and unwilling to double down. Ackland hadn't spoken for several minutes. Neither had Hiroki. Well? Ackland looked up at her and said nothing. The tension was broken by an incoming message over Noguchi's comm. Ms. Noguchi, report to the med center immediately. Ms. Noguchi, to the med center. Miriam Revna. She sounded agitated. Noguchi tapped the received button and looked at the rancher. You'd better pray they found Revna, Ackland. I didn't make him go out there, and if he hurt himself, it's his own fault. She hurried out of the rec center and was blasted by the afternoon heat. Ackland and Hiroki followed. She deliberately walked ahead of them to avoid further conversation for the moment. By the sound of it, Ackland was trying to reason with Hiroki, his deep voice apologetic and contrite. Asshole. Noguchi waited at the entry to the lab for them to catch up. If Revna was dead, she wouldn't want to walk in on it alone. The three of them stepped into the lab together. Noguchi saw what was strapped to an examination table and took in a deep breath. To scream or faint, she didn't know. Dragon.